Welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we will learn how we can install Visual Studio 2026 on Windows 11. So let us start. At first, go to the web browser. On Google, type Visual Studio and press enter. On pressing enter, the official website is visible. Click on it. So here is the official website, visualstudio.microsoft.com. Here it's written Visual Studio 2026 is available. So click try it now. After clicking, all the three versions are visible, the community, professional as well as enterprise. The community version is freely available. So we will download the community version. Click on the download community button. After clicking, the download started. The download is complete now. Right click the exe file and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. Click continue. So we have installed Visual Studio. From the workloads, now select .NET desktop development because we are also creating a sample project. So I'll click here. After clicking, here you can see this will install the .NET framework, also the IntelliCode, with that a debugger also. It will also install GitHub Copilot. So keep the default options. And here you can see that Microsoft Visual Studio will get installed in the following location. It will take 6.47 GB, not a problem. Click install. It will also install while downloading. Okay. So I'll click install. Now the installation started. Let's wait. Here it is downloading and installing. After installing, it will start because the checkbox is by default selected. Let's wait. The download completed. Now it is finishing up with the installation, and after the installation it will start automatically because the checkbox is by default selected. We have installed Visual Studio. It's visible here. Now it will automatically launch. Here it is. Now we can sign in from our Microsoft or GitHub account, but I'll just skip and click here. Now an option is visible to start Visual Studio. Let us start. Before that, select the development settings. We are going for the default settings, that is journal. Choose your color theme. I'll go for the dark theme only. After that, click start Visual Studio. So Visual Studio opened. You can directly create a new project from here, or you can click continue without code. I'll click here. Now we will create a sample project quickly. So here it is, Visual Studio. You can close this. Okay, I'll also close this GitHub Copilot. Okay, now let us go to file, click new and click project. Here different project templates will be visible. Here it is. We are creating a console app. So you can directly type console here, so that you can get different projects related to console. Here it is. I'll go for the console app.NET framework. Select this and click next. You can name the app. Let's say I'll name it Amit First Console Application. Below you can see the location of the project. Here is the complete path of the project and the .NET framework is 4.7.2. Click create. Now our first project will get created. Here it is, our first program is visible. This is the Solution Explorer, that is the Project Explorer. and here is the default code. We will print something now. This is a sample C# console application. Here we have declared a namespace. A namespace can have multiple classes, so we have created class that is accessible only within the same assembly. The interim point is the main function, just like in Java. It can be called without creating an instance of the program class. Okay, now let us print something. To print, we will use console.writeLine. And here I'll mention my name. This will output the text Amit Diwan. Okay, so I have entered Amit Diwan, it will output the same. Add a semicolon and press enter. Type console.readKey. Now what is this? When you'll keep the mouse cursor, it will explain you that this will obtain the next character or function key pressed by the user. The pressed key is displayed in the console window. Go to file, click save all. Go to build and click build solution. Semicolon is missing. Okay, yeah, this is fine now. I'll click rebuild. It is completed, successful. Now let us run it. Click the start button. Now it will print Amit Diwan. It printed it, Amit Diwan. Since we have used console.readKey, when I'll press any key, it will close. So in this way, we can install the current Visual Studio version. For a free C# and Visual Studio tutorial, refer to the link in the description of the video.